That being just days prior to Kadapurim, when we celebrate the miraculous survival of Klal Yisrael from the threat of annihilation, I would like to share a synopsis of the Rebbe's Sicha that is both timely and suitable for tonight's event, celebrating the mission and miracle of a holy parent. During the times of Purim, both Mordechai and Queen Esther were well connected with their government and king. Mordechai was part of the royal court of Ahasuerus, serving as an advisor to the king and had recently saved the king's life. Esther was, of course, Ahasuerus' wife, about whom the Megillah Talmud Tzvatim Tachem Lachet and Lechon. When the Gzeirah of Haman was issued, it would be most logical to assume that given their standing and stature in the eyes of the king, their first act to remedy Klal Yisrael from the Gzeirah would be to put to use their excellent connections and beseech Ahasuerus to save their nation. Yet, as soon as the Gzeirah became known, Mordechai reacted very differently. Mordechai garbed himself in sackcloth and ashes, went out to the midst of the city of Shushan, calling out on all Jews to do tshuva. Only after doing so did he instruct Esther to approach the king in order to withdraw the decree. Esther Amalka conducted herself in a similar fashion. Before seeking an audience with the king, she sent the message to Mordechai. Leich kenei tiskal yehudim hanimtzayim b'shushan. Go and assemble all the Jews in Shushan and fast on my behalf. Do not eat or drink for 3 days. Moreover, she said, I too shall fast as well, even though the fasting would cause her to appear unpleasant in the eyes of the king. Yet, explained the other, both Mordechai and Esther realized that the Gzeirah was the result of improper behavior among the Israel. And so, their first act was to inspire all of Klal Yisrael to tshuva. Only then did they pursue other channels as well. The story of Purim teaches us that the first step to ensure survival of Klal Yisrael must be to strengthen our bond with Hashem and His Torah and His mitzvahs. Then, and only then, can we secure the future of Klal Yisrael. The survival of Klal Yisrael never was, nor will ever be, attributed to natural and logical survival tactics. The Torah and mitzvahs that made us into a nation is the only ingredient that will continue to sustain us as a nation. The lesson we take from this is most suitable as we gather to underscore the vision and mission of Holy Torah and celebrate its remarkable 56 years of educating and inspiring a generation of Siddim and Shluchim. The mission of Holy Torah, as established by the Rebbe, is to educate and inspire Tinegei Shel Beis Yavam only at Tarek HaKadosh. And while secular studies are seen by some as a necessary means for survival, the Rebbe told us otherwise. Holy Torah was established by the Rebbe's calling in the spirit of Mordechai Nachman. We will not safeguard and secure the Kedusha and Yerushalayim of Klal Yisrael by succumbing to habits and customs of modern civilization. America is nicht anders to clear the Friedrich Rebbe exactly 72 years ago yesterday kept other from these shores. And which institution in the world and more justice to that statement of that our very own Holy Torah? And as for being able to navigate the modern world we live in, the graduates of Holy Torah are not only not inferior, to the contrary, their pride in Ge'en Yaakov allows them to be much more successful and effective, just as the other predicted. To me personally, Holy Torah is very much part of my life. Not only because I have attended Holy Torah for the past 14 years, and I'm proud Holy Torahnik indeed, but also my mother, Zoltan Gizun, has stood to take part in the chinuch of youngsters in Holy Torah for many years as an education director. And my father, Olav Shalom, and the schools I speak before you tonight, was a truly dedicated member of the Holy Torah team, leading Tinegei Shel Beis Yavam daily in the pathway of Torah and Siddur, as he did with a special warmth, cheer, and smile. So as you can see, Holy Torah is truly part of our family tree. In fact, it nourishes and fortifies the roots and branches of our family, along with many thousands of families of Siddur today who stand in the forefront of preparing the world, the Kabbalah and Mashiach who came. It would be remiss not to mention those who have the greatest impact on me personally in Holy Torah. The dedicated Malamdim will give it themselves, B'lev Nefesh, to educate, guide, and inspire us. To the Na'al Klali, Rabbi Rosenfeld, I give you my Birkas Kainim that you should continue to go from strength to strength with much Erchav and Lukas and Nefesh. To tonight's honoree, Maura Fahey, the devoted preschool director who laid the foundation for our kids. And to the dedicated dean, Rabbi Lustig, who together have deeply impacted all of us at Minim and remain a source of inspiration well beyond their school. To the Mahar of Nevi Masipur, where I now attend, Rabbi Willem, who inspires us all to grow in Teriyah, Darkest Sidis, and Yerushalayim. And a special mention to my present teachers, Rabbi Gaizinski and Rabbi Laziel, who give us the real geschmack for the learning. To them, to my mother, Bubby, family, and each one of you, I conclude with the bracha that includes all wishes and aspirations. As you ever quoted the Chazal, Mismach Geula LeGula, from the Geula of Purim to the Geula Amitit Rashleimah, through these galaxies of the Rebbe Malach HaMashiach, take it from Yad Mahar.